Hello friends, in the last video, we had seen the second hypothesis test to compare the mean of two samples, that is, paired t-test in Microsoft Excel as well as Minitab software with the help of a practical example. In this video, we are going to learn the third hypothesis test to compare the mean of two samples, that is, two sample variance test or two sample standard deviation test in Minitab software with the help of a practical example for easy understanding and better clarity. As this test cannot be conducted in Microsoft Excel, you need to use statistical softwares like Minitab. So let's begin. Two sample variance test. Use two sample variance test to determine whether the variances or standard deviation of the two groups are different and to calculate a range of values that is likely to include the population ratio of the variances or the standard deviation of the two groups. For example, a healthcare consultant wants to compare the patient satisfaction ratings of two hospitals. For this purpose, the consultant collects ratings from 20 patients for each of the hospitals. The consultant then performs a two variance test to determine whether the standard deviation in the patient ratings from the two hospitals are different. Hypothesis for two sample variance test. For a two sample variance test, the hypotheses are as follows. Null hypothesis, H0 colon sigma 1 upon sigma 2 is equal to k, that is, the ratio between the first population standard deviation sigma 1 and the second population standard deviation sigma 2 is equal to the hypothesized ratio k. If you are testing the ratio of variances, then replace standard deviation by variance in the hypothesis. Alternative hypothesis. Select one of the following alternative hypotheses. H1 colon sigma 1 upon sigma 2 is not equal to k. That is, the ratio between the first population standard deviation sigma 1 and the second population standard deviation sigma 2 does not equal to the hypothesized ratio k. Or H1 colon sigma 1 upon sigma 2 is greater than k. That is, the ratio between the first population standard deviation sigma 1 and the second population standard deviation sigma 2 is greater than the hypothesized ratio k. Or H1 colon sigma 1 upon sigma 2 is less than k. That is, the ratio between the first population standard deviation sigma 1 and the second population standard deviation sigma 2 is less than the hypothesized ratio k. Again, if you are testing the ratio of variances, then replace standard deviation by variance in the hypothesis. Data considerations for two sample variance test. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect the data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. 1. The sample data should be selected randomly. In statistics, random samples are used to make generalizations or inferences about a population. If your data is not collected randomly, then your results may not represent the population. 2. The sample data should not be severely skewed and the sample size should be equal to or greater than 20. If your sample size is greater than 20 and the underlying distribution is unimodal and continuous, then the hypothesis test performs appropriately, even if the data is mildly skewed. If your sample size is less than 20, you should grab the data to check for skewness and unusual observations. If the data is severely skewed or has many unusual observations, use caution when you interpret the results. 3. Each observation should be independent from all other observations. The independence of observations is determined by whether one observation provides information about another observation as follows. If an observation provides no information about the value of another observation, the observations are independent. And if an observation provides information about another observation, the observations are dependent. If your observations are dependent, your results may not be valid. And 4. Determine appropriate sample size. Your sample should be large enough so that the following are true. The estimates have enough precision. The confidence intervals are narrow enough to be useful. And you have adequate protection against type 1 and type 2 errors. To determine the appropriate sample size for your hypothesis test, go to Power and Sample Size for 2 variance. I have already explained the detailed procedure for it in the general procedure to conduct hypothesis testing. If you want to see it, please click on this card. Example of 2 sample variance test and confidence interval. A healthcare consultant wants to compare the patient satisfaction ratings of 2 hospitals. For this purpose, the consultant collects ratings from 20 patients for each of the hospitals. The consultant performs a 2 sample variance test to determine whether the standard deviation in the patient ratings from the 2 hospitals are different. The consultant then follows the steps for doing a hypothesis test in line with the general procedure. Conduct a 2 sample variance test in Minitab. Enter the collected data in Minitab worksheet and then follow the procedure. 1. Select stat, basic statistics and then 2 variances. 2. From the drop-down list, select both samples are in the one column. 3. In samples, enter rating. 4. In sample IDs, enter hospital. 5. In options, as we are comparing the standard deviation of 2 samples, select an option of sample 1 standard deviation by sample 2 standard deviation, which is a default. If you want to compare the variances of 2 samples, then select a second option for variances. 6. Here, the confidence level is 95%, hypothesis ratio is 1, and alternative is ratio is not equal to hypothesis ratio. As a default, keep them as it is and click OK. 7. In graph, select the type of graph you want to use for analysis, and 8. Click OK in each dialog box to get the results. We will get the results of an analysis in the session window and in graph window. Interpretation of results. In these results, the estimate for the population ratio of standard deviations for ratings from the 2 hospitals is 0.658. Using Bonnet's method, you can be 95% confident that the population ratio of the standard deviations for the hospital ratings is between 0.372 and 1.215, and using Leibniz method, it will be between 0.378 and 1.296. The null hypothesis states that the ratio in the standard deviation of the ratings between the 2 hospitals is 1. Because both the p-values are greater than the significance level of 0.05, the consultant fails to reject the null hypothesis and does not have enough evidence to conclude that the standard deviation of the ratings between the hospitals are different. Please note that skewness and outliers in the data can adversely affect your results. Use the graphs to look for skewness and to identify potential outliers. In these graphs, the data do not appear to be severely skewed, but in the box plot, it shows that hospital B has 2 outliers. This is all about the 2 sample variance test with the help of a practical example. We will see the next type of hypothesis test with a practical example in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful, add your valuable comments and share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.